While presenting the budget framework paper for the office in the coming financial year 2023-2024, before the Parliament's Presidential Affairs Committee, officials of the Office of the President informed Parliament that the country has run out of the highly prestigious medals bestowed to heads of state and governments who visit the country. The medals include Most Excellent Order of the Pearl of Africa and the Distinguished Order of the Pearl of Africa.
These are honors bestowed on visiting heads of states and government, and therefore pose a risk in failure to decorate an invited head of state with the appropriate national honor.
4.23 billion shillings, which was requested for by the Office of the President, has not been allocated in the budget framework paper, hence posing a risk of embarrassment due to failure to decorate the visiting presidents.
If a visiting head of state is awarded a medal, this does not stop here. It will be mentioned in the countries where they are coming from, and people get to hear. Some people will pick interest in Uganda through search.
In the same vein, the Office of the President is seeking 2.2 billion shillings to organize three national functions, including National Liberation Day, Heroes Day, and Independence Day, to take place under the 2023-2024 financial year. However, this money has also not been allocated, leaving a funding gap of 2.2 billion shillings. The Office of the President is also grappling to facilitate the ever-growing number of presidential advisors. 8.3 billion shillings was requested to facilitate the 139 appointed presidential advisors, but only 3.5 billion shillings has been earmarked in the budget framework paper, leaving a funding gap of 5.1 billion shillings, which is needed to produce vehicles for presidential advisors.
His Excellency the President appointed 139 presidential advisors. This necessitated that Office of the President provides an enabling environment to enable them deliver on their mandates. As such, 8.3 billion was required for their facilitation. However, only 3.2 billion has been provided for rent of their offices and allowances, leaving a funding gap of 5.1 billion.
However, the committee members questioned the bloated number of RDCs and presidential advisors who create a huge burden of public expenditure.
There's nothing that is being done by them. So is it like that Museveni is trying to create jobs for the people who failed during the elections? So we need honestly to be very clear. There are serious priorities that we need to focus on as this country. The issues of unemployment. Look at the RDC sector.
The burden of renting offices for RDCs across the country is also taking a toll on the Office of the President. According to the Security Minister, Jim Muhwezi, it will take Uganda 107 years to construct office accommodation for all RDCs with a current rate of funding of 1 billion shillings per financial year.
The rental fees being charged for office accommodation are increasing and have become unsustainable. We appeal to the committee to provide 7 billion only to enable the office construct at least 10 offices per year.
Meanwhile, officials of the State House also appeared before the committee and decried budget cuts of 42.9 billion shillings.
I will propose that let's have further engagement. If you can reprioritize these unfunded priorities and we discuss with them, so that in the last cycle of our budget process, probably the circular may provide for some of these things.
State House seeks 21.95 billion shillings for procurement of vehicles for the President and Vice President. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.